Hello friends, welcome to Commoner Series. In this video, we'll be seeing what is investment and what are types of investment and how basically we should invest. So most of us, we earn money monthly and we spend the money for our day-to-day expenses. But after spending, at the end of the month, we'll certainly have certain amount of money which we save for future. So this savings need to be properly directed to make it as investment. The concept of investment helps us smartly allocate funds so that we take care of our current needs and also we can take care of our future needs depending upon our lifestyle. So basically, this investment is not just about money, but it also needs our time and thinking process. So only if we think on what to invest and how to invest basically upon our needs and necessities, then we'll reap proper profits out of that investment. So traditionally, there were certain types of investments which were available to us in India. So there were mostly options like gold, real estate or in fixed deposits in bank. So but today into this 21st century current world, we have new types of investments also possible. So we'll see about both traditional form of investments and also new types of investment in this video. So traditionally we were investing more on gold. So when we buy gold today, we buy it for certain price. But in future, definitely due to inflation and the demand and supply dynamics, the price of gold will go up and the price at which we buy today and the price at which we sell tomorrow is deemed as profit, and that is our gain gained from that investment. Today we also have certain new type of gold investment called as gold bonds. So this gold bond, it avoids physical gold, but it has all features of gold as we buy it physically. So this gold bond can also be used as collateral to buy other investments like land or a house. So the second type of traditional investment is real estate. Real estate can both be land or a house. So this real estate, it also works on demand and supply graphics. Today we buy a land, tomorrow definitely the population will increase and the demand for the land will also go up. In that way, we'll gain more money when we sell the same piece of land. So that is the profit gained from that piece of investment. So apart from that, there's also fixed deposits in banks. So fixed deposits, it is a very safe variety of investment. In fixed deposits, we invest the certain amount of money we have and the bank, they agree to provide certain percentage of interest upon the money which we give to them. However, even though fixed deposit is considered as one of the safest way of investing, the returns from the fixed deposit, that is a profit made from this source of investment, is very, very less. In the terminology of investment, we need to understand one factor is that the more risk we take, the more gain we'll gain. So the risk factor is directly proportional to the returns. So in investments like fixed deposits, the risk is very, very low. Certainly we won't lose our money, but at the same time, the profit we gain from the fixed deposit is also considered low when compared to other sources of investment. In the new times, we have other options too. So the first option we'll be seeing is the stocks. So the stocks is also known as company's shares, and this is one of the most famous forms of vehicle in today's investment cycle in India. When you buy a company stock, you actually buy certain amount of ownership of the company. The companies which offer stocks are the companies which are publicly listed in the stock exchanges. Say we have Bombay Stock Exchange in our country. So in the listed companies, you can buy the stocks and thereby claim the ownership in the company. So when the company performs well, the stock value of the company will raise than the amount you invested initially. So after a certain amount of time, either short term or long term, when you sell the stock, you will sell it for a larger amount and thereby you will benefit from it. But investing in stock should not be confused with trading in stock, which can go even in a speculative way. The second option we'll be seeing is mutual fund. So in the stocks which we saw before, when we are investing, we need to have certain minimum amount of money and we also need to have proper time to check about the company's balance sheet, its performance before investing. However, most of us, the working people, we don't have that amount of money or the time to invest in. So there's another channel called as mutual funds. Here, there are certain institutions which are specializing in mutual funds. They pool in money from a lot of people and they invest the larger amount of money so that they get larger benefits in certain institutions. This will definitely ensure optimum returns since proper research is put before investing. These mutual funds, they can be investing the pool in money into equity, that is stocks, thereby it is called as equity mutual funds. And if they are investing in bonds, they are called as debt mutual funds. However, there are also options for mixing both of it depending upon the risk the customer wants, and they are called as hybrid mutual funds. So these are the famously available options in investment. Apart from this, there are also other high profile options like investing in startups, becoming an angel investor or a venture investor. But all these are possible only if we have larger amount of money and willing to take a larger risk. As I said before, only the risk we take is directly proportional to the returns we get. So in options like startups or angel investing, and the investment is done in a proper way, and the returns we get from that investment is very, very high. There are also other options like employees, provident fund, national pension scheme, which are for targeted audience, which are also considered as investment channels in our country. So before investing, we have to know about our needs and our priorities. Certain factors which basically need to be considered before investing is age. Lower the age, the better is the investment. So all of us need to start investing at the early age. Number two is a goal of investment. So what are we investing for? That needs to be clearly known before investing. Some people will be investing to buy a house, or some people will be investing to take care of their retirement needs. So depending on that, the investment should be channelized. And another important key point is before investing, we also have to check the tax benefits we'll be gaining from the investment. Certain investment channels, they provide us with tax benefits. So if we are in that category, we can invest smartly so that we get tax exemptions. And on a final note, the investments at the starting stage can be made simpler rather than investing in complicated stuff that we don't understand. So it is definitely beneficial for one to start investing as early as possible and invest smartly to generate more wealth. Thank you.